This is Susan Haynes, and we are still in November 2011, and I want to talk about the dynamic programming solution to the sequence alignment problem. Now, the sequence alignment problem is I have two strings of characters coming out of some alphabet, and so the example I'll be using to start with is the example out of a textbook that we happen to be using this term by Kleinberg and Tardosch. And the example strings are these two. I've got the string mean and the string name. Now, when I look for an alignment between these two strings, what I want to find is the best alignment. Clearly, these two are not the same string, so I'm going to have some cost associated with aligning these things. Now, there are a number of ways I can align them. So I've got one possibility written right here. And I can write out another one so that you can see it. Like so. Okay. In this case, I've got the EAN aligned with the NAM. So that means this NM here has to be aligned with a blank, and this E, we have to insert a blank there. Since I have a number of different possible alignments where I can insert blanks or I can have characters that are matched with characters that differ, I need to have some way of measuring or calculating how good the alignment is. And the way we do that is by calculating the cost of the alignment. So if I have two characters which are the same, like I'm matching up an A and A, that will add a cost of zero to this particular match right here. If I'm matching up two consonants which are different, that's a lot better. That's not as costly as matching up a vowel with a consonant. So we want to punish vowel-consonant matches. We want to reward perfect matches like this. And then if I have consonant-consonant matches like this, or like over here I have a vowel match to a different vowel, we want those to cost something but not be so bad. Also, if I am forced to add gaps in here, these blanks, I'll want that to cost something. So in this example right here, these things are determined ahead of time by looking at the kind of alignment that we want to get, and then based on, you know, the data that we're looking at or the kind of alignment we want to get, what we want to punish, what we want to encourage. We've got two kinds of things. There's the gap cost, which is labeled delta, and that's given the a priori value of 2 to start. And then we have the alignment, the matching cost right here. And for this particular example, there are three values. 0 if it matches. 1 if it's a consonant to consonant where the consonants are different, or a vowel to vowel where the vowels are different, and 3 where it's a consonant to vowel match right there. So in this particular case here, where I match mean to name like so, then M to N has a cost of 1, E to A has a cost of 1, A to M cost of 3, N to E cost of 3. So altogether this has a cost of 8. Here, M to gap, I have a cost of 2, E to N cost of 3, A to A is 0, N to M is 1, and gap is 2. So this altogether has a cost of 8. And you can see there are several different possible matchings that you can have. Okay, now what the dynamic programming approach says is that when I have a particular string that I'm looking to match, and I have found an optimal match here between the earlier parts of the string, and now I want to find out what's the next step optimal match here. So you can imagine this is my string ME that I have optimally matched in some way to the string N. And now I want to know what's the best step for the subsequent match here. The best step for the subsequent match is going to depend on what's happened earlier. And so the dynamic programming approach is going to find optimal solutions to the subproblems that precede the current state that I'm in, and then use those subproblem solutions to build our total solution. So let's take a look at the matrix that we need to make this happen. Okay, so here's our matrix right here. And I'll write out my strings right here so that we can maybe get a real concrete feel for what's going on here. Okay, this position right here, let's call this matrix A. Okay, so this position right here, A of 0, 0, right here, says that the cost of matching an initial blank, see, I've labeled my rows and my columns with the character going down left to right. So the cost of this blank to blank matching right here gets initialized at 0, and that's our starting place right there. Okay, so that'll have a cost of 0. Now we're going to use the gap equals 2, and the alpha will equal 0, 1, or 3, depending. So I'll just write it down there for our convenience. Okay, now the cost of this match right here, that says I want to know what is the optimal cost for advancing this string down the end, but not advancing this string. See, if I'm moving down NAME, I'm moving down this way, but I'm not advancing down the MEAN string. So in order to advance down the NAME string, but not the mean string, oops, I spelled mean wrong, didn't I? M-E-A-N. Not the mean string. What I'm looking to do here is insert a blank, a gap, that I want to match that N against right there. And we can see the cost then for that match right there is 2, because I had to insert a blank. Now to compute what the cost for this right here would be, I've got my mean, and I have computed that I have a blank. I'm going from here to here. So I've computed, I've got a match right here with optimal cost of 2, and then a match right here of optimal cost of 2. So that goes to N. And now what I want to do is advance down the name string, but not advance down the mean string. So this needs to get matched with an inserted blank. And we can see right here the cost of this is 0 plus 2 plus 2 is 4. Okay, and so on. As I move down the main string but keep stuck on the mean string, I'm just inserting blanks, gaps in the mean string. So this would have a cost of 6 and this 8. Similarly, going up this direction right here, I have my mean and my name, and we computed the initial, this is our starting, like a base case of a recursion, the initial value is 0. Now I want to move down the mean string this way, but not advance on the name string. So if I'm moving down the mean string, but not advancing on name, I'm going to insert a gap right there. Okay, so that means I have an added gap cost of 2 right here. And similarly, this will have a cost of 4, 6, and 8. Okay, now we can move on to interesting stuff. Let me erase this. It's no longer necessary here. So. Okay, so now I want to look and see what's the match here if I'm matching M against N. So matching M against N here. Okay, now we can see there are three ways to get there. One way is here, and that is that we have matched the blank against the blank that precedes right here, and then we move forward one down the main name string, and we move forward one down the mean string. So that means going to here. Okay, now we can compute what this cost is right here. This cost for this, we don't know anything about what follows yet, but so far the cost for this is 0 and the cost for this is 1. Okay, so far I have a cost of 1 for A of 1, 1. Cost of 1. Now there's another way I can get here, and that is to go this way. Go up from here. Well, what is that talking about? That says that I have matched the initial zeros. In fact, I just did this and erased it then, right? And I advanced the N, but I did not advance the M, so the N is matched against a blank, right, to go from here to here. And then I need to advance the M, but not advance the N. So I need to advance the mean word, but not the name word. So to go up, that means I'm advancing on mean, but I'm not advancing on main. So I got to here from this point right here. I'm at this position here, and then I move forward on mean, so that's this one right here, but I do not move forward on name, so that's this right here, and then I will have name off here and mean off here. Okay, so in order to do that, I will need to insert another blank right here, see, to match with the M. So I take this and insert a blank. A blank has a cost of 2, so this will have a cost of 4. 2 plus 2 is 4. So that's another possibility, is to go this way. Okay, and then the third possibility to get here is here. And in order to go from here to here, well, I started here, and that matched my blank against a blank. And then I went up, so that means I advanced the mean word, but I did not advance on the N word. So there's a blank there. And now I want to move over to the right, so that means advance on the N word, but not on the mean word. So there's a blank there. So then here I have E-A-N following and A-M-E following, but what I'm looking at is right here. Okay, so to compute this, I have my optimal cost from before, which is this thing right here, 2, plus insert a blank. So 2 plus 2 is 4. So I have altogether 3 ways of getting to this position. I can go this way with a calculated cost of 0. I can go this way with the cost of 4. Or I can go this way with the cost of 4. Now what we want is to minimize the cost of the alignment. So we will take the... this should be cost of 1, right? It's 0 plus 1 gives me 1. So I want to go this way right here, because 0 plus 1 for the cost to align M and N gives us a 1 right there. So this is the direction I want to go. So let me color that so that you can see it very clearly. The optimal cost is 1 at that point, and we got there from our starting position right here by advancing down both words. So right now, this right here is for this initial part of the string, this is the optimal cost.